Hello and welcome to Magzie's Fun Time. This is Magzie, and we are back here on Affinity Skyblock Evolved Expert Mode. I finished off my platform here. This is as far over as we're going to go. I'm probably going to go ahead and surround this with a wall, cobblestone wall for right now. When I get a diamond, when I get an upgraded chisel, I'm going to replace all this. I'm not going to right-click all this at one time, so we're just going to wait, replace it all at one time. I'm also might go ahead and replace the slabs here with cobblestone. That way, when I do get the upgraded chisel, I can just go ahead and knock out the whole platform. So, I have made this slightly longer than what I initially wanted to. And also, I have added 3 rows on the side here, just so I can grow some extra rubber trees. Now, a couple of notes. One of my viewers upgraded to the 1.1.0, and I am using the 1.0.4. The reason I'm doing that is because I haven't tested out the 1.1.0 yet, and I don't want to upgrade until I'm sure that it's not going to cause no adverse reactions. Okay, but in the 1.1.0, he can't get these to grow. Now, there are several different rubber tree saplings that you can get. There's not that. Let me show you. Hold on. As you can see here, there's 3 different kinds, okay? You don't want these 2. You just want this one, all right? So if it doesn't say this one, don't use it. Just pick it up, put it in the chest, try again enough time. Excuse me. Also, I wanted to show this on camera. Actually, I need some more drawers. Let's move you up and then grab a little bit of... one meal? Yeah. I get a stack. So, if I right-click on this in 1.0.4 version, you can see it grows. Alright? Just to let you guys know, I'm not treating and getting this stuff in. It grows on its own. I will start a world in... or I might upgrade and then go into my test world first. And test this out on their world. If your bone meal's not working on these... there's another... I'm going to just make a little bit of this. There you go. You can make this. This is called fertilizer. And what you do is you put avatite in the middle. And that gives you 8. And it acts just like bone meal, except that it is not bone meal. So you can try the fertilizer if the bone meal is not working for you. And as you can see, I'll do it again. There you go. Now, I will upgrade and then try both of these out in 1.10, and on the next video, I'll let you guys know. I also posted on the forums that it wasn't working for one of my viewers, and I still haven't got anything back on that. I don't know if it's a glitch or not, so I don't want to post it on the glitch the bug forums if it's not a bug. So. I'm asking people there, and when I get a response back, I'll let you guys know. I might, if I would get a response back, post it on this video, and then I'll talk about it again on the next video. Also, I put another drain on here, and I've just got one each of the immersive engineering barrels here. One on each drain. That way, whenever this is empty, I can switch this out for this one. And then I could just make obsidian. Just what I do is I use these, and I put 4 in one, and then 4 in the other one, and then I do that over and over again until this thing fills up with obsidian, and then I put 4 and 4 in there again, and then I start draining it out, and that works out pretty good, and it doesn't fill up with all one or all the other one. Also, we're getting low on coal cook, so I have been using As we can see, we're out of power again. And I am going to shut that off for now. I don't want that running all the time. I just want it running whenever I got stuff in there. Because this power is fine, but this stuff I've set up, and as you can see, that's out of power. So I've been using charcoal for right now, just until we get auto gravel. I need auto gravel. I don't need it to auto sieve. I just need to reduce the amount of time I'm waiting for it. And how we're going to do that today is I have in here, I've been making some extra chipsets here. As you can see, we got a few in here. I made one diamond and gold and emerald. I might make an emerald one too. I don't know that many recipes that I'll be using for the emerald ones, but hey, you know, you might need it. I also expanded this out to right here. It is going to go out all the way over there, and we are going to put the storage down here. Also, some of my machines are going to go down here also. But the first thing we want to do today is I want to make a macerator. Now, last episode I did make some crushed obsidian here. So I want to go ahead and my objective here is to put the macerator right I want to put the macerator right here, okay? So when I make it, I want to put it right here, and then we'll run power up from the bottom. I think I can do that, okay? And then I'll show you what I'm going to do from there. So first things first, we want one of the chipsets in here. And we want to move this around like that, and that gives us a basic machine frame. And we also want a... one of these, and I do need some redstone. Wow, was that all my redstone? Where did my redstone go? Oh yeah, I used it in the thing. I'm gonna have to do some dust. There we go. And then if I come down here and click on macerator, I can out of cobble. Let's grab one more of those. And there we go. And I do want to put this right here. Now, I got lava here, so I want to put that in there really, really fast. It won't melt this. There's nothing that lava will do to this machine right here. Also, I also want to make a upgrade for this. So let's get 5 of these. Actually, I need 7. There we go. And, I want to make this thing right here. So, and then, no, this. It's you. And why is that not? Oh, there we go. It should work now. 2. And I need the chipset, which I don't think I have enough copper for. Let's grab a little bit more copper. I really need more copper. I got wires over here, guys, but those are for a specific item that we're making today. So I want to make more of the regular. Rubber bars. As you can see, I got plenty of rubber bars. I'll grab those. There we go. Now I'll be able to make this. One of those. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and make this one too, because I need that one for another one anyway. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do this. And this is the ejector upgrade. Now, it will eject to any one, but I want it to come out the front. So I'm going to right click on the front here and then put that in there. There we go. Now, what this will do is that means it'll eject out the front. Now, the next thing I want to do is for right now, I'll make another one, but I want to move this one over here. Like that. And then we want to take this top off right here. And then if I grab my pipes here and do that, that's weird. Oh well, it won't go in there. It'll go in here. And then as you can see, no, come on, what's wrong with you? Why aren't you doing? Do I need to pull upgrade too? Don't tell me that. Why you not do? Do I need it on the side here? I didn't test this ahead of time, so if you guys are wondering. Let's try. Are you going to fill up the cobble? Can't put it in there manually. That's so weird. How else can we do this? What if... what if I did another hopper? If I put a hopper on here, like this, am I not gaining then? Yeah? It must be going somewhere else. It's not going there, which means it has to be going here. Yeah, so if I can't take you out. Oh, goodness. That's really annoying. Because it's the same distance here. What if I, for the time being, took you off? And I just put you in like this. Will you go in now? You will. And then... I don't think I actually need the hopper here. Let's take this hopper off. Yeah. I think it should auto-input into here. Now, if I take you out... Yes! Okay. Good. That's what we want. And then we'll put the extra in here. So, what I could do is make this go all the way around and then hook it back into the side here. And then it'll always fill up in these two first. But it would be just as easy to put a speed upgrade on here so it fills up faster. We'll see. Speed upgrade. I don't have the redstone right now to do that, but it's working now. Now we need to get this thing powered. Let's throw some stuff into here. And we can use our medium voltage. I got some more medium voltage stuff here. And I think it will hook up to the machine here. Nope. There we go. I'll do that. And then I do this to there. Will that get power? Is the question. No. It will not get power. I'm just going to drop down in here. Let's take you off here. And if I run you from there to there, you can get power now. I think I might have to run regular cables up there. Which is fine. I can do that. We don't have any power. That might be the issue. Yeah, that might be the issue. Let's check that. Yeah, we're not running. So we can do a double loop here. So do it like that, and then that should gain power because that one has power. Get there. No. Okay. So that's not working whatsoever. All right. Let's take you off and take you off. It's because this is an HV. And this is an input, not an output. So let's put you here and then you here. And do I have my hammer on me? I do not. If I put you here, will you connect these? Yes, you will. And it's working. Yes. Ow, what the heck? I don't know. The only thing I can think of is I jumped on top of the rock crusher there. It's cool. It's my first death. Death by machine. Okay, and as you can see now, this is popping them out. And hopefully it won't use that much power up. But this will be another nice passive way to get gravel. Just gravel. And what I can do is, I believe if we take one of these gravel out here uses. If I put it back in the macerator again, I'll get sand. So what I can do is I can stack these up. I can have this eject. I can take this ejector upgrade out of here and just make it a generic ejector upgrade, and it'll eject into either one of these. So I can have a macerator here to turn that to sand, and then if we look at sand, here. Come on. It'll go to dust. So my objective here is to get three macerators running, all going into these compacting drawers. And then I will not need the compacting hammer, which means I don't have to waste all those diamonds. And I will have three compacting drawers right here, all making their stuff. So before the next episode, just so you guys know, I will have three macerators running right here. Okay? These chests will be gone. And I'll have three macerators right here all working into compacting drawers. And then I never have to worry about doing the hammer. And I can just sieve anything I want. Then the next episode, we're going to work on some auto-sieving. Which I believe is going to involve me just manually putting into the sieve for right now. I don't know that I need these putting in. I mean, if all else fails, I can I don't know. I can move these out one, maybe? I don't want to actually move those, do I? Maybe I can put some kind of an item duct on here and only pull out the compressed version. Maybe? But, I don't know. We'll figure something out. But anyway, I want definitely want the gravel auto sieving. So I'll probably feed this into auto sieve automatically and have it the output. Sorry guys. Sorry. I had to sneeze. Auto sieving out. Definitely want these auto sieving because we want the what we got here? We got 4 cold coke, and then I'll grab a couple of those, and we'll just drop down right here. This will give us a little bit of power. Basically, I've been farming trees, and I've just been making charcoal and sticking in these for now. Because I haven't been sieving, which is my basic problem. And then back here, we'll just throw in about 5 of those, and that should be about the same. See, this uses it so fast. I'm thinking cold coke is not going to be the answer here. I'm thinking maybe charcoal will probably be better off using in these generators, because it doesn't seem like it lasts that long, and the blocks last for a pretty long time. Can we make charcoal blocks? I still want to use the cold coke, but I'm thinking I'm going to need a whole lot more for the generation. Also, this is fully. This one's full. This creosote, because it only holds so many stacks. So 128 is all it will hold in here, and I don't really need no more right now. I do want to put it into something though. Let's see here. I do need to fix you. And you. So you're coming along good. You're doing the compressed. That's all I need. I want to do the metal former next. So what we need there is some bronze plates. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I need another hammer. Two sticks. And pretty soon we won't have to do this ever again. There we go. No, not you. You. Okay. So I do want another basic machine frame. There's that. And then I want 2 chests, which I had the stuff for. There we go. And then this will give me 2 toolboxes. And then if I come down here and hit middle, there it is. Oh, I still need to make these, which means I need 3 iron. And I used one of them. I used my iron on some. Oh, dude, come on. There we go. I'm almost out of iron, too. I have to be careful. And that is what these wires were for. I needed 3 of these. These here. It will not shift click into here. I know I was going to try, but it won't. And then at the top, we need the chip. And there is our metal former. And we are just going to hook this up downstairs with wires. I want to... I think I want to come out 1. And then come out. Yeah. And I've got a little bit more. That'll do for right now. And then I can put that there. And it'll disconnect. It won't get power because we don't have power going to these yet. But Let's go up here. It was in the wrong one. Dadgummit. It should still smell. There should still be power in here. Come on. There we go. That's 5. That'll get them running enough to fill some power up. Now, between now and the next episode, I'm going to make it where these autofill. And how I'm going to do that is I'm going to put a pool upgrade in each one of them. And, what that should do... Okay, you're full. Yeah, you're good. I don't want you doing no more. I need that anyway. That should be enough to get started with. And then we won't have to worry about this anymore. Okay, so how I got this set up right here. We're making a compressor today too, hopefully. Hopefully if I have enough. I have 2 low voltage capacitors. I always hook these 2 up. And I've got medium voltage running into these. And I've got outputs on the front and then on this one side right here. Okay? And then both of these... or feeding to each other and feeding into the top, and they are getting power that way. So, Here we go. A little bit more power. It seems like that's all I'm doing is running power. There's 2. There we go. Anyway, I'm going to put a pull upgrade in all of these, and it should pull out from the chest on the side. And then if I put... if I put one chest here, and one chest down there, and then one in the back here, and then I just fill all those up, for now, it'll automatically feed in through using those upgrades. And then I can get some... pipes going later on when we get to the pipe level. Also, I don't want to waste any more of my iron here, so I'm going to stick this iron in here. And we want it rolling. We're just going to have it make some more plates. 3 is not going to be enough for what I want to do. Nine, 8. There we go. It seems like all I'm doing is running back and forth, but I do want the compressor up today. I don't want to have to go to the next episode to do that. And I don't really need power to do that other than to run the... the metal former here. And it will fill all these up, and then once they're filled up, it'll just get the power for here. It won't take too long to get these, though. Actually, that'll be enough for the actual frame. So let's look at the compressor. Go down here, and we hit come. Compressor. It is just a... really simple. Wow. Okay. Let's go get one more. There we go. And we will need some more copper. But I can do that. We got plenty of copper right now. Let's do 12. And we'll just make these manually for now. Since we're having power issues right at the second. Actually, I need a couple more of you guys. Got that. That. And you know what I forgot downstairs? Chipset. It's lucky I made extra iron chipsets. Because this will take so much longer. There we go. Now, why did I want the compressor this episode also? Because off camera I can go ahead and do up some of the refined iron plates and get that going. And then we want stone, which I have already smelted up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Got this, got that. Compressor! Awesome. So we need a bunch of... I'm going to just set this right here, actually. And we're going to pop another pipe onto the side of here. And that won't get power because these don't have power yet. Oh, this is taking forever. There we go. It does use a lot of stuff. I know one thing that I can do until we get all of our production up and running. Is just use planks. That should get you power. Yes. Okay. So if I go up here now. And I grab, I just need 4, I believe. Yes. And there's a reason I want these. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and have these be rolling into plates. And by the next episode, on the next episode, what we're going to do is we're going to probably get... I'm going to do some machine frames off camera. Machine frames. Not you. These. Basic machine frames is 2 crushed obsidian, a dense refined iron plate, which is just the steel. That's why I want some of that. 10 gears, which we can make, these basic circuits, which we can make, and then the iron chipsets. Well, I'll make some more of those, and then I'll have a couple of these going, and we'll make a sawmill next episode also. So that's what we're gonna do. If you like this episode, we also might get a lumberjack axe. If you like this episode, make sure you smack that like button. If you subscribe to my channel, I'll send you notifications when I have new videos out. You can come check them out and see if you like them. If you do like this episode and you want to share it with your friends, tell them if you liked it. There's a share tab down below. Click on the share tab, copy the link, post it in your Facebook, Twitter, wherever you do your social media. One more thing, guys. I did put the on level 8 up there, just some glass up there, just so they wouldn't grow too big. And the reason I don't want them to grow too big is because I want to be able to just come in here and just take them out. I do need to start taking these leaves out, though, because we are going to need a large amount of dirt for our farming, which I don't want to wait on. So I'm going to probably want... I'll build the area off camera. So, and I'll tell you when I'm going to do it, but I'm going to make little 3x3 sections. I want a big, large area to do that with. So, I don't know how big that's going to be just yet. Anyway, I'll see you guys on the next episode.